This video explains how to use the network door controller to open a door when parents or other authorized pickup people for children successfully check children in or out through a check-in station, or if a staff person of yours checks a child in or out through the receptionist feature inside Procare. Also, the door controller is used to control whether the door opens or not for employees as well. Let's get started.
When you first receive the door controller, you'll see it in a shrink-wrapped package like this. We'll go ahead and open this package and take a look at the contents here. So the first thing we'll see is the door controller itself. On the door controller, we have a serial number and we have what's called a MAC address. A MAC address is an electronic address specific to this device on your network. On the end, you'll see a connector here for your door circuit wiring that will connect to the door controller. The door controller acts as a switch to open or close the door controller circuit. The door controller circuit is not supplied by Procare, it's supplied by someone outside of us, and you would have a wire that you could connect to this door controller, and you might be able to see here there's a C on this terminal, there's a NC for the center terminal, C is here, NC is here, and NO is here. C stands for common. So you attach one wire to this terminal here, and you'll attach the other wire of your door circuit wiring either to the NC, which is normally closed, or to the NO, which is normally open. Normally closed is generally used for a magnetic lock circuit, and normally open is generally used for an electric door strike circuit. Here's the power. We'll plug our power into here when we get the power out of our box. And on the other end of the door controller, you'll see the network connector end. This is where our network cable that's included with the door controller. This one of the ends of this plug will plug in here. The other end of the plug will plug into your router, your network hub, or network switch. There are a couple of lights here that we'll look at in a moment after we connect to the network. And there are two lights on the side, a green light and a red light. The red light comes on when you have power. When you've plugged power into the end of the door controller here, the red light will come on. The normal state for the green light when it is connected to your network is to be off. If you see the green light flashing, it means that your door controller is not connected to your network. It is on, it's got power, but it's not connected to the network. The other state for the green light is on when the actual buzzing of the door circuit occurs, so that when the switch activates in here to complete the circuit to open the door, you'll see the green light come on. On the other end, we'll have an orange and a yellow light on the network connector, the Ethernet connector. The orange light just simply indicates it's connected to your network, and the flashing yellow light indicates network data going back and forth to the device. So let's go ahead and set this up. Included in the network controller are the instructions for installing your network controller on your network, the standard states of the lights, and then setting up your door circuitry here, and the settings inside the Procare check-in computer, and the receptionist settings. So those are included. We'll go through that in our video. Let's begin by simply unwrapping everything. So we've got a standard 6-foot cable here, network cable. You can have a network cable up to 328 feet long. So if you need to locate the door controller far away from your router, you could do that. You simply just get a longer one of these cables so you can plug it into your network. The power supply is included here. Go ahead and unwrap this. And I'm going to plug it into the wall over here. Plug the power into it, and you'll see the red light. Red light comes on, and the green light is flashing. The green light is flashing because we're not yet connected to our network. So let's go ahead and connect to the network. Plug one end of our cable into the door controller. The other end will plug into a router or a switch like I've got here. This is a standard 10/100 megabits per second switch, and I can plug the other end of my wire into any one of these connectors on the switch. Once I do that, the green light goes off. So the normal state, once you're connected to the network, is to have the green light off and the red power light on. And then we'll notice over here, the orange light indicates we're connected to the network. The yellow light indicates we're getting network traffic to our device here. So this is the normal state things should look, just like that. Your door circuit wiring might look something like this. And when you go to connect the wires, you'll probably have a low voltage electrician do this for you. But you would take one of those wires, as I said before, connect one of them to the common terminal here, screw it down like that, and then you would connect the other wire either to the normally closed, if you're using a magnetic lock, or a normally open circuit if you're using an electronic door strike. So that is something like what the normal door controller assembly would look like after it's in place. You have a mounting screw right here, a hole right on the bottom here, when you can attach this to the wall if you'd like to mount it to the wall before you plug in these other wires, and you're ready to go. And let's go take a look at the software and what you need to set up in the system for this to work properly with either the check-in computer or receptionist.
First, we'll take a look at the check-in computer. We'll go into the options by simply double-clicking anywhere in the border area, or if you have a touchscreen, you would simply double-tap here to get into the options for the check-in computer. When you go into the options, we'll have a hardware button right here. So this is where we're going to go to look at the door controller settings. Click hardware, and you choose whether you're using a serial COM port door controller or a network. So I'm going to select network here. And then to find it in my network, I'm going to go ahead and click select. Our network is set up to automatically assign what are called IP addresses, or a network address within the network, to every device when we attach it to the network. So my door controller should show up in my list here when I click select. It's going to go ahead and look for them. And it's finding my door controller, my serial number on the door controller that we just looked at is this serial number, 1014. So you can identify it pretty easily. And here is the IP address assigned by our network via DHCP. If you need to add a device that you cannot see in the network because you don't have browsing turned on, but your network administrator knows it, they can go ahead and put that IP address right here in these four boxes and add it. And then the test button here allows us to test the door controller. When I hit the test button, the program sends a test command to the door controller and we'll get a success message. And you'll see the green light light up on the door controller, as we see here. The advanced button would be used to edit the description. So instead of it being Procare DR, I might go ahead and type in something else. Just door controller, if that's what I would like. Or I could even make this a little bit more generic and do something like DC1014. That's the serial number for it. I could also call it front door, back door, whatever I'd like to do there. Change the name of it. And then I can update the device. And I want to update the device name to DC14. So now that will go ahead and change that name. So when I see it in my network, I now see it as DC1014 rather than the serial number by itself and Procare DR. The next thing to set would be the delay between the time that a person successfully checks a child in or out and the number of seconds you'd like the door to remain open. So you'd set your delay. You could have that set to immediately, and that means off. Or you could say, I'd like to delay 2 seconds and then have the door open for 2 seconds and so on. And you can test that right here. Also, you can say, if for authorized pickup of children, I want to require check-in and out for the door to open. Same thing for employees. You can say, I want to require the employee to complete the check-in and out process or not. So if you have employees who leave the building and need to get in and out of the building, You might want to uncheck that for employees. That way, all they need to do is supply their credentials and the door will open. So they don't have to actually check in and out. And now let's go take a look at the receptionist settings. For the receptionist settings, you'll want to come to the Procare home screen, come to the configuration area, and then go down to your machine settings. In the machine settings, we're going to click the receptionist features for our network door controller here in the options. So we'll select receptionist door controller network. Then we want to uncheck the box not using a door controller. Once we uncheck the box, we can then choose a device in our network. Remember that I changed the name of our device in the network to DC1014, so I'm going to select that. That's all I have to do there. And my duration, how long do I want it to buzz open when I click this option from inside the receptionist? I'll say 3 seconds. Once again, when I click the test button here, the green light on the door controller will come on. So once those settings are set, we can then go into our family data and accounting section and click functions, attendance tracker, and receptionist. In addition to opening the door when a staff person successfully checks a child in or out, you also have an open door button at the bottom, which when you click it manually, will open the door without performing a check in and out of a child and stay open for the duration you've set in the settings for how long the door controller will stay open. And that's how to use the door controller from inside the receptionist. That ends the video on how to set up your door controller and make the settings in either the Procare check-in or in the receptionist to use it from within Procare.